You just never know what you're going to find here at Jolla Shores.
Yesterday was really clear.
We're like, wow, we saw leopard sharks and rays and everything else.
Specifically, we've seen opalescent nudibranchs, tuna crab, sheep crab explosions.
Here at the shores, our big event, of course, is the squid run. The squid run is huge. Usually every year, and then they kind of stop for a while for reasons we don't know.
It's definitely changed. Water temperature, visibility has changed. Our diversity is less, I guess.
Yeah. Visibility is really low, and those clear days are like, oh my gosh.
I hear stories from other more experienced divers about what they used to see, and we just don't get them. So it's very disappointing.
So when I was a kid, I grew up in Los Angeles, and we used to go out to Catalina. And there would be these big boils of rock cod that would come up to the surface. But when you go out there today, you don't see that. People are not stupid, for the most part. They may have different concerns than the environmental community. And climate change, it seems very distant. When it's reported in just degrees of temperature rise, over the last couple of years, that just doesn't seem, they don't have any framework to be able to understand what that means.
And having someone enjoy being outside and, spend time in nature and falling in love with nature doesn't always translate to the behaviors that support conservation. And so that was sort of a reckoning I had sort of midway through my career, that you have to go a little bit further to actually create change. The knowledge to action gap essentially refers to when a person has the knowledge to perform the necessary actions to care for the environment, but for many reasons they don't perform consistently with that knowledge. Drawing from conservation psychology, behavioral science, social science, and also anthropology to just really get people across the finish line and in creating change, knowing that you can't just give knowledge. That's not enough, and that you have to also rely on principles that are rooted in marketing and other communication strategies to get folks to actually change. And that's what fascinates me is, how do you change people?
I've always found that the tactic that a lot of sales people use is like, I'm going to convince you that you need this or that you need to do something about this. Knowing that people have the choice, whether they want to litter, recycle, buy products that are better for the environment. It's a choice. So me trying to convince them is going to be a lot more challenging than me trying to inspire them. So that's what we do. We take inspiring stories about the environment, about people doing amazing things to preserve our public spaces, and obviously here in San Diego, the beautiful beaches. And people will remember that, and they'll be inspired by it because they'll associate it with something personal to them.
Climate change is here now.
It's a stewardship role that we have as human beings on the planet to take care of things.
When I go diving, then I not only record my dive, but also I do reef.org, which is doing a citizen scientist survey dive. So I put it into a database of what I saw today, and it helps scientists look at the species and the number of the things that we actually see and the abundance of what we see also. And they can get a sense of that over time.
We're a consumer society, so put your dollars where the most good is.
Right.
Right. Lower your consumption first, and then when you are consuming, vote with your dollars.
Exactly.
Sure.
Exactly.
It needs to happen in the classroom, at the kindergarten level, all the way up to college, undergrad, postdoc, etc. It needs to happen at the policy level. It needs to happen everywhere.
And see younger children coming up, and they know about certain topics. They know about animals more, and they're teaching their parents. So they're learning at a younger age, and they're definitely more sophisticated about what's happening in the world. And so that's a big change.
Just do the things you can do in your own life and watch what the ripple effect is around your community and then maybe your city and then maybe your state and your country and beyond.
We're fancy today.
Legit.